in the first story is what and why is scaling. Alright. So you know what we do is we go around the table and you know I would request to share your viewpoints that why scaling and what probably we start with what is scaling so that we come to a common understanding first and then probably we will take into the second part of it that why scaling really is required so that we understand that where all it can apply and fit. Alright. So who wants to go first?
What is scaling?
You can introduce yourself. So we missed introduction part, and Imran was reminding me. So we have missed an introduction. So the good part is before you start speaking, you introduce and then you talk.
I'm sorry. Can I get one more chance? Because I might also.
So introduce yourself and then talk about it.
Is there a standard about introduction or just
No standard, free flow. Okay. Something which helps all of us to relate to you.
I'm Sanjay Kumar. I'm a trainer and coach working with Eisenbridge right now. I've done Agile for I think at least 5 years in my total work experience of 15 years. Yeah, that's introduction. So now coming back to what is scaling. Scaling is, especially in terms of Agile, is having teams long more than certain numbers. Agile, the reason we ask about, we talk about scaling in Agile, not in, say, waterfall, is Agile mandates a team of, 6 plus minus 3, or sometimes we used to say 7 plus minus 2. So there is a limit, because that limit enforces better collaboration. Because there is such a strong limit from, Agile, Scrum, and all these people. We need to think about whenever the project is bigger, we need to think about scaling. So there is a special focus on scaling in Agile, like there is not in, say, waterfall. Anybody else?
So who wants to go next? Right. So do we all commonly agree that, what Sanjay said,
yes,
that pretty much, we have a limitation on our, the team, because beyond that, it's hard to manage, but you might have larger projects. So in order to, scale that, how do you figure that up, right? Is that what just Sanjay said? So do we all commonly agree that
that's what I just kind of a scrum of scrums.
All right, okay.
It's also scaling, I believe.
Okay, so what do you mean by, can you elaborate on scrum of
scrums? Scrum teams are working on different modules of a project.
Sure.
And finally, they collaborate and tell the status of every module.
Fair.
As a project.
Fair.
Where are we standing as a project? Not as a team, individual team, as a project. Where are we standing?
Yes, yes. So can we categorize it, what you just said, as what is scaling? Probably that's one of the features of scaling. Can I say that?
That is one of the solutions.
Solutions, yeah. In order to get to what we really want.
Okay.
Does that mean
to achieve the scaling?
Yes. So what I would say is that, what just Sanjay said, that is, to help.
Help go beyond 5 to 9.
Yeah, help increase the team size. Team size beyond
9.
Can we.
And also helps to manage multiple teams.
Helps to manage. Okay, so helps probably would come into the solution part of it. Can it come? What? Yeah, probably. But this word quite probably, I would like to have a discussion on this word called manage probably because in terms of Agile and Scrum, we probably would like to have more of self-organizing teams.
You can replace it with organize.
Yeah, I'll organize the team probably. Yeah. And that's just my viewpoint. If somebody wants to speak, feel free to, take this. Fair enough. So shall we move on to the why part of it? Do we all agree? Yes, no would help.
Yes.
Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll say that why do we need this? Why do we need even scaling at all? Okay. Why can't we just simply say that, hey, divide the project? Why do you need to even scale? Alright? Why can't we think about in isolation, ye chota sa project? Why can't we break down the project itself? So who would like to go first?
There are situations where we get projects which are huge in scale. Okay, so if we have just one scrum team, you know, maybe of 9 people working on it, it might take years and years to complete. So we need more people, we need more hands on the job to work on that project and complete that work within the given deadline. Deadline could be because of market reasons, deadline could be because of economic reasons, deadline could be because of any other factor for that matter. So, but at the same time, how do you then organize your team, your entire workforce? So that is where I believe the why part comes in, because then you need to scale Scrum. You still want to get the best of Agile. You don't want to fall back onto the waterfall model. You still want to be Agile. You still want to get the benefit of following Agile practices. At the same time, you know, you want to work beyond the constraint of a small Agile team. So that's the reason.
So, what I gathered from you is that market could be one reason which would pose.
No, not exactly market. The reason, the thing is, the scope of the project is this big that it can't, if just a team of 9 people works on it, it will take them years and years to complete. And by the time they complete, if at all, the product will be no longer.
So I would summarize that into 2 points. One is scope. The scope is huge, that's why you need to scale. The other thing is schedule. You want to schedule, if you know, whatever a 9 member team might take, you want the schedule requires it to be so much sooner than that, of course.
Sure. Okay. So one aspect I would like to bring, because it goes hand in hand, that definitely, you know, when it comes to an IT project, probably scope and schedule could be the driving factor for an IT perspective. But really, at the end of the day, if we look at from a customer perspective, probably this could have been the reason for them to say, "Here, I need it in 6 months. Now you figure it out."
So market could be the reason behind this schedule.
Fair enough.
Why do you need it? Why can't I give it to you in 3 years? So he might say that, 3 years from now, if I start with, if I have a Facebook competitor, yeah, it will be irrelevant. Mm-hmm. You must have captured the maximum market share. So schedule is the driving force, and market is what is put in that.
Yes. So who would like to go next?
So, like Vaibhav said, the market.
Your introduction first.
Yeah. I'm Saurabh Vishnoi. So the other thing I would like to mention is the 2 important things for the software projects are the currently the market operates is the time to market and the quality that we give to the customer. So the time, because right now the scenario is that if you do not have less time to market, some other competitor would actually take the game from you. So we need to scale up, and quickly we want to scale up, and that too with quality. So I think those are the 2 factors. The time to market and the quality, which would be important to decide about the scaling.
I think we are focusing too much on the reasons behind schedule. The D factor is schedule. Schedule would be because of X, Y, Z reasons. I think we are focusing more on those X, Y, Z reasons than on the schedule. The prime thing is schedule. As I said before, schedule would be because of yes, market, because of government regulation. Right, I mean, let's take an example. The Prime Minister just announced that all banks have to provide accident insurance by 31st of May. Now, you can't have a 9 member team working on it and delivering it by 31st of December. It just won't cut it, it just won't work, because that's government regulation. Now, there could be financial implications also. The budget is announced every year on 28th of February, and is applied on 1st of April. So, you can't change that date. You can't say that I'll ship the minimum viable product by that point of time. So I pick up cherry pick items from budget and do those by 1st of April and implement risk, see how market responds, see how people respond, see what the backlash is, and then take it forward. So the bottom line, the point I'm trying to make is we are focusing too much on the external factors, but I think the de facto factor why we need to scale is schedule. We want to deliver a product in n number of days, which if just a 9 member team is working, then it will be actually delivered into n into 9.
I think you can summarize that 3 S.
size, schedule, and scope. Right?
Yes. Because see, you know what? What?
Yogesh.
Yes. So size. You know, I think yeah, size is something also. You know, probably something to be discussed.
Size of project is same
as scope, but yeah. You can take it as a project size as well.
What do you mean by project size?
Scope.
What do you mean by scope?
Means I'm just telling it, you can take it any ways.
Then it should be two ways.
Okay.
So, okay.
Then size would be team size.
Okay, so size is team size, you are right. Saying. Okay. And schedule of the project. And scope. Okay, fair enough. Please pardon my handwriting. I wanted to become a doctor, by the way. So. Okay, so who wants to go next?
I would like to come back to the question or the possibility you mentioned in the beginning when you were talking about scaling. Is why not break a project into smaller pieces? Right. So the reason, even if we break it into smaller pieces, and let's say there was a way to break a project into such smaller pieces and such independent pieces that the individual teams do not need to collaborate at all, then that will be a perfect world. But in most of the cases, if they all belong to one project, more likely than not, those individual teams, they might be relatively independent, but they will still need to collaborate in due course of time, right? So they are not truly independent, and maybe that could be one part of the solution then. So split the work, but still we need some ways to those individual teams to collaborate on a regular basis. So the entire project goes on schedule.
So without work breakdown, you can't be scaled. It means you can't assign different teams to different modules because you have to still break down the project. So sub projects you can take it as. Okay. So it is necessity for scaling.
What is necessity, sorry?
Means you have to break down the entire project into some smaller modules.
Smaller modules.
It's necessity.
Okay. So I think, we got a very good point on collaboration. So probably, I don't know, it could be a driving force or not, but definitely one of the key aspects to be looked at, during scaling, as well as even why scaling, I would say that, is there a problem in, collaboration in my teams today? Probably that's why I need to look at a framework where it guides me in terms of doing the collaboration in a right manner. It's not only about one project, but I might have different projects, but some way or the other, in today in IT world, I can't say that there will be no interaction between multiple.
But I think that would be advantage of scaling.
Fair enough. Exactly. So what? So probably this is reason enough for me to scale. And I want to improve my collaboration.
Right.
See, I guess my understanding of the story is that we are trying to figure out that why should I even scale? What is it that hampers my possibility of doing it in the right manner? Right. Correct me if I'm wrong. If that's not the understanding. Right? My understanding is why should I even scale? Right. Fair enough. Anybody else would like to go forward? Okay. So I will summarize, and then we will see some of the key whys which we should take from here. So I understand. I think Weber very nicely spoke that scope and schedule, right? That's what you said. Is the most governing factor,
right?
That why I should even scale. Do we want to give a consideration that the way we collaborate today, could that be a driving factor in terms of scale? Because that's a very interesting aspect, I personally believe.
Collaboration is within the agile team. I didn't get the question.
So what I'm trying to say is, the moment we said that why can't you divide your projects into smaller and just deliver it with multiple teams separately, probably in a logical way, all right? Versus saying that, for example, even if there is a regulatory requirement, there might be, we should be able to break it down. That's what we always suggest. So I have already multiple teams, I just give that portion. Alright. Okay. So could the way I am collaborating today, alright, is a problem area for me. That's the reason I should look for a framework or a scaling process through which I can govern my I could guide my collaboration model today in the organization.
More than collaboration, it's a problem of coordination.
Coordination.
It's specifically dependencies, because
that's what coordination.
They are part of the same project. Coordination is probably the solution, but the need for scaling is, even if you divide one big project into small chunks, there is a natural dependency because they are part of one bigger whole. So there is dependency for which collaboration and coordination, these are the solutions. But the real need is there is a dependency that you cannot neglect at all. And in agile world, you know, the reason for limiting the size to 9 years, that's probably the optimum size, you know, based on research or whatever practice they have seen. The 5 to 9 or 3 to 9 these days to say, that is the optimum size for enhancing the collaboration piece, which becomes difficult if you know, scale, if you have, you know, one single team of say 50 people and doing Scrum. So collaboration gets impacted.
Collaboration is basically, let's say, you know, I might be a project management expert. Someone else might be a financial matter expert. The other person can be a legal expert. Now, we need to build these requirements. Each one of us is not sufficient, okay? We have to do what? We have to collaborate. We have to, you know, bring our knowledge together and, you know, work on it. Yes, we are interdependent, definitely, yes, but here the need is collaboration. When you divide your project into different modules, and each of the modules is more or less independent. I mean, yeah, they will tie down into one, but each of the modules is more or less independent, and that's the reason you have divided them in the first place. And if there are different teams who are working on that, then they need to coordinate. Okay, so you know, team A might have dependency, as you said, on something which team B is working on. So they need to coordinate. Okay, when will you be done with this? And so that, you know, we can plan our work accordingly. So here it's like, okay, fine. Once we know that coordination is there, once we know that, you know, this is gonna happen, we might not be collaborating on the work if we just, you know, take it in a very focused way. I mean, collaborating on the whole, yes, but not collaborating on the micro pieces. But we are coordinating our efforts. So it's just, I don't know what best example is, but let's say a game of soccer. At any point of time, there is just one person who is holding the ball. He's not collaborating with anyone while he's, you know, controlling. He's not collaborating while he's controlling the ball. But all 11 of them are actually coordinating. They are dependent on, you know, each other, the strikers, the defenders, so on.
Yes. Alright, so, do we have more time on this topic? Can we take it on?
That's one question. You are the
facilitator. I'm a sub facilitator on that.
So, one question. I did not get the point of financial. Why is financial?
I just wrote what are some of the keywords you were writing so that I don't miss anything. So, he just said that, you know, market conditions, financial conditions can govern our scope and scale. I just kept on writing, you know, so that I couldn't lose those keywords which he just.
Just to add on to that, talking about the soccer game, like the example which he gave, I think it's about, when we talk about the efforts, that's the collaborative effort.
Yeah.
But that resulted from the coordination between different players.
Yeah.
So that's what we can look at, the scaling thing. That different teams coordinate with each other, but the effort is collaborated towards the end result of the product. So the effort is collaborated, but yes, they do coordinate, and at times they do collaborate if they have dependency on each other. They do work together as well, but I think even if they're independent, they all work together for a common objective. That's for the product. So the effort is collaborated, but yes, they do coordination with each other to make that thing happen.
You know, the reason why we use this is, you know, when you ask this question, that maybe we are not collaborating in a better way. I believe we are collaborating today with internet and, you know, with shared tools. Collaborating better, but we are not coordinating better. I mean, I might be collaborating with three authors in formulating a blog post, but I'm not coordinating with them. I don't care about their deadline. I'm not worried about their deadlines. You know, I'm just, they send me a piece, I just work on it, and as long as I'm keeping my part of commitment, I'm good, and that's being done with it. So that basically what collaboration is. Coordination is when, you know, the different teams are, you know, making progress in a synchronized way. It's not that one team is far ahead, the other teams are lagging behind, and the others have not even started. That's basically what the relationship is. And that's where there's, you know, collaboration, coordination.
Talking about words like coordination, the two key things which I personally see, that coordination has a sense of synchronization. So time synchronization, that's one thing.
Yes.
The other thing is it has a little bit of, you know, a sense or smell of central or centralized decision making.
Not really. Coordination.
Coordination.
Yeah, absolutely.
If one person is, for example, doing,
absolutely.
The way commonly it's used in management is coordination, one person is taking decisions, right? So in teamwork, your collaboration, for example, right? Collaboration also sort of includes coordination a little bit because it's need-based. And the other thing is the decision-making is distributed. Decision-making and initiative, both of them.
Okay. So, two aspects. Okay, so the word why, why scaling? You can look at it two ways. I mean, that's just fairly my opinion. All right. One is the factors which drive you. One is that, why really you are prompted. I mean, what I'm trying to say is, why in terms of that, these are the factors, like for example, scope and schedule, puts you in that situation to start even thinking about scaling. All right. Another why could be that I do certain things today, in order to do it better, I should look scaling. For example, there are five pillars which I believe Scrum suggests: plan, produce, inspect, adapt, and transparency in the whole process. Right? In order to have a synchronized and a better planning is why I should look for scaling. That could be one viewpoint. One viewpoint is I'm put into a situation because I have so much of scope and a specific schedule is why I am forced to scale. I hope I'm making sense here, right? So these are two different aspects to look at. One is fear of failure, probably. One is more of motivated reason to do things better. So for a while also, there are always two aspects is what I believe. Even in the general life also, one is motivation due to fear, here come basically the neck would be tanquani. Probably it could be one. Or probably it is one that hey, I am doing something really exciting in my life that that motivates me. Probably that could be the case which why we are here on a Saturday. That's more of a motivation, probably.
Yeah, and secondly talk about two things, towards and away from.
Absolutely.
Two kind of motivation.
Absolutely. And probably one aspect which is
towards motivation towards something or motivation away from something.
So probably I would also like to say that we should categorize these two ways in the same format. Probably these are some things, the situations which makes me think that why I should do that. This is more of inspirational or motivational that hey, I would like to plan better. I should be in a position to plan better the way I do, probably for bigger teams. For bigger teams, that's the reason I should look at scaling. Probably in order to produce more, I should look for scaling, probably in order to do the right way of inspection of what I did, probably to adapt the process in a better way, I should look for scaling practices, given a given bigger team, and in order to have transparency. I mean, that's just my viewpoint. Any viewpoint, anyone would like to add on this second part of it, that the motivational part of it?
Motivation is more about
how
we are motivated, right? Then why? Why exactly are we, why can't we, like Weber said, why can't we limit our team size to 9? 9 is the time, 9 is the team size which has been practiced, based on practice and psychology and all those experiments.
The collaboration channels.
Yeah. 9 is the optimal size for collaboration. So why can't we stick to 9 and do the project whatever time it takes?
Yep.
So the thing is, so there is some need of scope,
yes,
and schedule that we have to do it. And then maybe about how, okay, it will help us plan better, produce better, and all those things for a bigger shipping list.
True. Okay, so I think
we'll summarize.
We'll summarize. Yeah.
Anybody wants to summarize this? Or how?
That'll be great if somebody
will
take
this. First, we define the definition of scaling. So, what is scaling?
So, shall I read it? So, help increase the time size beyond 9, help organize.
So we are agreeing to, so whenever we talk about scaling, we primarily look for a way to work with more people. That's it. Okay. So we are defining scaling that how to work with beyond 9 people. So we are in agreement of it. Great. So we can write it somewhere. So we don't
take a picture.
No, we write it. So maybe you write it, with a normal pen. So that is something we can conclude on. So that's the first part of it. And then why I think went into a long discussion. We spoke, we started about time to market, so scope,
Vaibhav was making point related to time to market, like you need to deliver fast, and in order to deliver fast, you need to put more machines to work on. Like if you only have one machine which is producing some goods, may not be able to produce in a night. If you want to put 100 machines, may not be the 100 time, but yeah, maybe some faster than something else. So that is the need of why part of scaling. Anything else coming out of this particular discussion? Can we mark this done then?
Yeah.
Great.
Done?
Yeah, welcome. Okay, so we are done with our first story, and we know what this scaling is all about. And these are the two results which we have. So what is scaling go beyond agile teams of 9 members? So this is, I'm putting our results somewhere here. And then we have a second thing coming is why scaling, big scope, fast schedule, cross-team, order collaboration. So these are something which we would be talking about. Great.